Hello, my name's Solar, and this is pretty much my first time doing something like this. This is Ori and the Blind Forest. It's a game I've been anticipating for quite some time, and I'm pretty sure it's gonna be very popular quite soon. It's definitely a hot game happening on Steam at the moment. Let me see. I think it's been created by Moon Studios and published by Microsoft. So it's released on PC, Xbox One, and 360. Of course, I wanted to record this game. I'm really happy to record this game as my very first game, and I hope to continue doing series like these in future. First of all, just double check my settings. Yeah, got everything like 1080, full screen. I'm not gonna show the damage values just yet. Yeah, it's gonna be my f this is my first playthrough, so let's just get used to that, used to the game, get to grips with it. All right, I've been playing around a bit just to see if my settings are correct, and I hope you guys enjoy. Let's just delete this. Let's just start up. Here we go. This is just the beginning of the game, of course, and yeah, we take control of the big guy. I'm not too familiar with his names yet.
Sure.
So yeah, that was the beginning. So did they give us a chance to get a few of the character? I actually felt kind of sad there, having to play the character in the last moments where it seemed like he died. Alright, well, let's just get started. Looks like you might need something to get through her. Yep. Hold down an A to get down. Ooh. Found a small spirit light container. Spirit lights has been added to your this. Find more spirit light containers to quickly gain ability points. Alright. Like you can move midair, that's great. Cool. You found a life shard. Collect these to restore your vitality. Not sure what these things are here. You found an energy cell? You can now collect and use more energy. Remember that you can use energy to create Soul Link and save your game. Okay. So this is my checkpoint. That's great. House on Spirit Light. When you find this, you can gain ability points. Okay. Oh, okay. It's kind of like experience points. All right. Okay, ability cells grant Ori an ability point. You can use ability points on the ability tree. These are all locked. Shows how many times Ori respawned as Soul Link, so I guess that's my death ritual. Just trying to see how to find the world map, but just checking through the buttons. Okay, so it's back. Oh, I'm playing on a 360 pad in case anyone's wondering. Pretty sure it's obvious now by now. Okay. Thank you. doesn't look like I can get up here just yet. Found a keystone. Keystones are used to open spirit gates. Remember that each spirit gate will require a different number of keystones. Sonic rings, aren't they? Mm-hmm. Looks like we need a new ability. Found a life cell. You can now retain more vitality. Find more life cells to increase your survivability. Into that. We found an energy shard. Energy shards restore power to Ori's energy cells. Okay, so the little blue thing at the bottom left, well, center of the screen, but yeah, left side. don't have any. Oh no, I was thinking that end bit here was part of this. Guess not. Nice. I can hold down to look down. Just wondering if I drop down, can I get back up? So we should go exploring somewhere else meanwhile. Guess not. Yeah, well done. So let tap B near the any access ability tree. Not quite getting that yet. You have learned wall jump. Use the ability to push the left stick toward a wall and press A continuously to leap forward. I think they should have called this wall climb, but whatever. Well, I suppose it is a jump. You found the energy cell. You can now collect and use more energy. Remember that you can use energy to create Soul Link and save your game. Cool. May as well save it here. And just gonna pause it for a moment.